This year, NTD will hold its 9th International Classical Chinese Dance Competition. We sat down with a candidate to understand more about the costs and rewards of living the life of a professional dancer.
As a dancer, you're always moving around, and so you're always very fit, I guess. So usually when you eat, you could eat like whatever you want. So it doesn't really matter. You could just, eat whatever you want.
Most exciting time is like lunchtime?
Yeah, when you eat.
19-year-old Michael Hu is from Feitian Academy of the Arts in upstate New York. Outside school, he goes on tour to perform around the world. His journey with classical Chinese dance didn't start out smoothly.
I didn't really like it back then.
The strict routine of a dancer didn't easily fit this teenage boy.
We normally wake up around 7 to 8, and then we have our morning routine, which is like stretching, kicking, bar, combo, off bar, and all that stuff. And then we have lunch. Sometimes we have academics or more dancing. And then we have dinner. And then at night we have more dancing again. And you can self-practice if you want at night.
All that stretching paid off when he started learning techniques. Like the technique Shen Dai Shou, where the body leads the hands, and Kua Dai Tui, where the hips lead the legs. These skills were once lost, but they're believed to reach the highest realm of artistic refinement.
So you first use force from your body right here, then it goes all the way into your hands. It's like the girl's water sleeves. Like they do this, and then the sleeves go out.
He said this technique helps make the movements longer, bigger, and more beautiful on stage. Hu was born and raised in the US. He says at first it was hard for him to grasp some of the elements of classical Chinese dance.
The teachers are always talking about the inner meaning, but I'm like, where's the inner meaning?
But through studying it, entering the minds of characters he has to portray on stage, he began to get it. In the dance piece he prepared for this competition, Hu will play the best-known tragic hero in ancient China, Xiang Yu. The cultural icon is portrayed in countless Chinese novels, poems, operas, and dramas. The rebel leader's matchless might and bravery couldn't prevent his eventual defeat and suicide. And his life was said to prove the role of fate and the ancient Chinese belief that higher beings are in control.
Even though he was one of the greatest warriors of all time, but heaven just doesn't want him to claim the throne for the emperor. So he accepts that. So he tells his fellow soldiers that it is not that I can't fight, it's that heaven doesn't want me to win. And so knowing this, he makes his last stand, and then he rather kill himself than surrender to his enemies.
Xiang Yu's overbearing pride is seen as his fatal shortcoming, and Hu says he keeps reminding himself about this.
One thing is you have to be humble, because there will always be something higher above you.
Step by step, literally, Hu starts to understand what his teacher meant by dance's inner meaning.
Like one movement could be done in multiple ways, all based on each person's personality. Each movement you do, you're basically trying to put your emotions into with your movements.
Hu says the dance training also improved his inner world, something his parents took note of.
They noticed that you become a better person, more tolerant, because after all the stretching you've gone through, you know what a lot of pain could feel like. And so you start to think like small things, they're really not that painful and that it's really nothing.
If you'd like to watch Michael Hu's dance and experience classical Chinese dance yourself, get your ticket for this year's competition at dance.ntdtv.com. The semifinals will take place at the Sugarloaf Performing Arts Center, New York State on September 4th, and the finals are on September 5th. You can also watch our live stream on ntd.com.